Now, you know it's a big deal when your boy OG skips the intro and goes straight into a video. You know it's a big deal. Now, I am dropping heat all week, right? Now, I want you to stop and think about something real quick. Your boy OG is going to break down every build for every single position, all right? I was grinding so hard, I had to skip an upload yesterday. So in these builds videos you guys are about to see, it's only right that you drop a like. Like up the video. Subscribe if you're new, because your boy put hard work, sweat, and I got all this. Do you hear this? This is all paper. It's all notes of every build in the game. I'm going to try to break the positions, break the builds down for you guys, so you guys don't have to be the same thing. Because all I see on YouTube is playmaker sharp or shot creator playmaker. However you say it, I don't really know, but that's all I see. I know a lot of you guys want to be different and you want to venture out with new builds. So I'm going to help you guys choose that one. Now, I'm going to break down each build. All right, I'm going to give you my preferred height, weight, and wingspan for that build. So what will help that build perform at its highest level, if you want to say. I got like 4 or 5 tips of what that build will be able to do. I will show you guys pictures, and I will give you guys NBA comparisons. Now, don't get mad, because all these things are not going to have NBA comparisons, all right? Now, also, down below, if you're watching the Playmaker video right now, or the Slasher video, or whatever video you're watching, down below in the description, if the video that you're watching is not the build you want to see, go down below in the description and click on the build. Today, I am dropping 5 videos on the point guard. So make sure you go to the description, and it may be up as a card, so you may be able to click it on the screen. But I know down below in the description, I will have the link to every point guard build down below in the description. So just click on that if this is not the video you guys want to see. So without further ado, give your boy some love, like up the video, and here we go. I'm giving you the point guard builds from playmakers all the way to defensive players. Let's do it. So the first build we're going to start off is with the pure shot creator. Now, first things I want to do is just kill that notion in your head that you got to be falling out of bounds. You got to be shooting J.R. Smith type of shots to be a shot creator, because that's in 2K17. They confirmed that in 2K18 that all the shot creators are is going to be a build that can dribble a bit and that specializes in the mid-range. All right, so we all know a lot of YouTubers are hyping up the shot creator playmaker. Now, low key, it's a nice build. But here we're here to talk about the first one. That is the pure shot creator. All right. Now, first things you can see is that the badges on the pure shot creator, you will have 20 badges, 8 bronze, 4 silver, 4 gold, and 4 Hall of Fame. Not 5, but 4. All right. So they left out a Hall of Fame ankle breaker badge. They just left that gold. So you have difficult shots, tireless score, teardropper, and mid-range deadeye. When I look at the pure shot creator, I see Isaiah Thomas. I see a guy who doesn't really pass all that much, but who has great handles. I think it's 23 to speed boost, but it may be 21. I don't know, but I think you should be able to get the elite dribbles. It's one of the two. Now, you won't be as fast as playmakers, but your mid-range is godly. Just imagine yourself 6'3", Isaiah Thomas, like, just in the fourth quarter all the time. This build is going to be a big-time scoring build, all right? So I feel like this build is definitely slept on. I feel like it's actually a good build, all right? It's a build that a lot of people should definitely test out. If you think about doing that passing and dribbling and you're not a big passer, you might as well just do this build right here and just have your mid-range max all the way out. And just do what you got to do, because the layups on this guy is actually still high. It is a 21. So your maxed out layup will be a 21. Your start off layups will be at 15. A great build, a great scoring build for the pro-am, a great scoring build for the playground. This is just a scoring build. I feel like this is one of the best scoring builds in the game. Now, this next one low-key caught my eye over and over again. Now, I did play this build in the prelude. And I somewhat kind of mess with it. Just somewhat kind of mess with it, right? So this build is pretty much the shot creating or the sharp shooting shot creator. So you'll be able to shoot threes, right? So this is basically a shot creator that can shoot threes. That's the easiest way to put it. So this build to me would be kind of like a Damian Lillard, right? So you will have all the ball handlers like dribble gods. Your ball handling will actually max out at a 20. No, 19. It will max out at a 19. Yeah, it will be a 19. You will start off at a 14. Your three-pointers will max out at a 20. It will start off as an 18. Your mid-range will start off as a 24, end at a 24. And your layups, which is very important to me because, you know, when it comes to dribbling, you got to be able to get past these people too. You will start off at a 14 but end at a 19, which is pretty decent. This build is pretty much balanced. Now, the thing that kills this build the most is the top end speed. You won't be as fast as everybody, but if you can work with having your cap at an 18 speed, then hey, go with it. This build will be lethal. You will be able to dribble, hit the mid-range, go out for three, be able to drive to the basket and make a lot of layups. You just won't be as fast. That's it. This is one of them Damian Lillard type builds. That's one of the best people I can imagine at this build because Damian shoots a lot of threes, but he does go to the rack, you know, and he is a mid-range god. You feel me? So this is the build for the people who just want to do a little bit of everything. This is another one of them builds I think that is low-key slept on. This is a good build. I tried it in the pre-loop. The guy was hitting greens, step-back greens, and that was the 55 overall. So make sure when you out here on the park using this build, you shout out your boy, OG, because you heard it here first. Now, I'd like to introduce you to the GOAT build. Every YouTuber is saying it. Oh, this is the GOAT build right here. A point guard, playmaking, shot creator. Because this is probably what everybody's making. Everybody's making this or a playmaking sharpshooter. Now, I played with this on the prelude. I'm not even going to lie to you. I ain't even going to front. This may be my build. But I don't know yet. I'm going to let y'all know that on Friday. But this may low-key be my build, bro. Another thing that jumps straight out at me is the speed. The speed on this guy, I didn't think he was going to be that fast, but it's going to cap out at a 22. So, and also your dribbling is going to be high. It's going to be a 23. So you're going to have a 23 dribbling. So pretty much you should be able to speed boost and you should be able to put on those elite dribbles. Now that depends on the height. Now the height, the arm length is all up to you. It's basically how you want your player to be. Another thing that stands out to me is his layups. Look at the layups. The layups will be capped out at a 20. You will start off with a 14 layup, which isn't bad, but you eventually will get to a 20. Your dunking will be at a 15. So pretty much, I think that would be like a 70 dunk. And if you think about NBA 2K17, 70 dunk was actually lit. It was actually lit. You can get all the dunking animations and stuff. Mid-range will be maxed out at a 23. So you have a 23 ball handling and a 23 mid-range with a 17-3. There's only one build that has a higher three-pointer, and that is sharp shooting shot creator. Pretty much you'll be able to do everything with this build, man. You'll be a dribble god. You'll be a scoring machine. You'll have the speed to actually play defense. You have lateral quickness. You have vert. Like, this build is all what everybody say it is, bro. This build will be low-key one of the best builds in NBA 2K18. Now, I don't know about y'all, but this build just looked goatish to me, man. I don't know what else to say about this build, bro. I looked at this build for the first time, and I was like, yeah, I can see myself rocking with a build like this. That's the defending shot creator. So pretty much what we got here is not only a speed boosting, well, this build won't be able to speed boost, but not only do we have a dribble-like lockdown defender who can actually shoot mid-ranges. So to me, this build reminds me of like a Mike Conley. Because, you know, Mike Conley got the straps and he can shoot. Well, Mike Conley is more of a, like a three-point shooter than a mid-range shooter, but this is the only NBA player I can actually think of. If you think of somebody, please let me know down below in the comment section. But this is just the only player I could think of. You'll be having lockdown straps where you can actually strap up point guards who are shot creator playmakers or playmaking sharps. You'll be able to lock them down. You will have an elite speed. Your speed will be 22 max and acceleration will be at 21 max. You will be able to dribble. You will have a dribble that's going to be 18 max. It's not that lit, but it's not that bad. All right, you will have a 21 maxed out mid-range, a 20 mid-range to start off with. Imagine having clamps and be able to score and shoot on a consistent basis. That's one thing that killed me about the lockdown defenders last year. They just wasn't able to shoot consistently. And this build brings you a little bit of everything. You'll be able to drive. You'll be able to dunk. This is one of the highest dunking shot creator builds out here. Well, it's tied with second with three other builds, but this is still one of the highest dunking ones. So your dunking will be maxed out at 17. Your layups will be maxed out at 18. And you'll still be able to hit the three maxed out at a 14. You maybe add some boost. You never know. Your man going to be turned up. This is a lockdown defender build. I don't think you lockdown defenders should overlook. This is a build that's low-key goatee. It's low-key godly, bro. So just make sure when y'all out there at the park, you don't run into one of these guys. Because this build right here could ruin your day. So here we go. Another build I really don't want to talk about because it's hard to actually, like, come up with good things to say about builds like this. This is the post-scoring shot creator. Now, like I said, as a point guard, you really don't want to be in the post. So if you're going to be a post scorer, make sure your man height and weight and arm length is maxed out. Because you don't want to be out there itty-bitty in the post. You feel me? You want to be a man when you're down there. Now, this build can low-key bully little point guards. There's no NBA comparison for this guy. This guy can get it done. If you know how to work this guy right, you will be deadly. Look at the layups on this guy. The layups on him is a 22 maxed out, 17 from start. The dunking is a 17 once you max it out, 13 from start. You will still have a mid-range of a 23 max, 22 to start off. So not only would you be able to finesse a nigga in the paint, you will be able to step out and hit the mid-range. Now, one thing you got to notice about this, or one thing you got to realize about this, is that you will be able to hit a lot of post fades, bro. You will be post fading, hook shotting. You will be up and undering on mad little itty bitty point guards. So when people bring their 6'2", 6'3", shot creator playmaker or they playmaker sharp, you could just put them in the paint with your 6'7" post god and hit that guy with a shimmy shimmy shake, 2 points. Now the only thing that really irks me about this build is that look at the speed. Now the speed is not all there. Now if you're facing up against a guy that's faster than you, he's gonna pretty much blow past you. It's a 14 to 18, so you got 14 to start off at 18 at your cap. But if you look over the speed, like I said before in previous builds, if you can finesse the speed, you're pretty much finessing the system. Get one of these guys down in the paint. It's going to be a GG. And don't forget, you can step out and hit the mid-range, bro. There is no player in the NBA like this guy right here. This guy is one of his own. Now, if you know any NBA comparison to this guy, let me know down below in the comment section. Now, you will get 22 badges with this guy. You have 8 bronze, 4 silver, 9 gold, and Hall of Fame teardropper. Now, when you're a post score, Hall of Fame teardropper is going to come in because you're going to get past that guy because you're going to have lit ball handling. You're still going to have that lit ball handling. So you're going to have lit ball handling. You're going to have lit post moves and a lit mid-range and a lit layup and even okay dunks. GG. Just wrap it up. This is a GG, bro. If you see this build on the park or the playground, whatever you calling it now, not only can he ruin your day, but this dude can ruin your win streak and even cause you to delete your build. Now, real talk, guys, I don't have much to say about this bill right here. I'm just going to leave it like this. You're going to be able to make layups with this build. You're going to be able to dunk. You're going to be able to rebound. You're going to have a decent three. You're going to have a decent dribbling. And you're going to have a good rebound for being a point guard. But I try to tell you guys to stay away from a build like this only because you're going to be going up against glass cleaners and 7'3 big men in the park. Now, this will be a build good for Pro-Am, but if you're in the park, I would say stay away from this badge. But you will still have that gold ankle breaker, gold difficult shots, gold tireless score, gold mid-range dead eye, gold teardropper. Now, I'm not trying to convince anybody not to do a build, but if I had to convince you not to do a build, I would say stay away from these rebounding point guards, rebounding two guards, all right? Do rebounding when you start hitting that small forward and up, all right? So that's all I got to say with this build. On to the next one. So last but not least, one of my favorite builds. Now, this is one of the builds that I'm thinking about creating. Okay, so this is the slashing shot creator. Now, this reminds me of a young Derrick Rose or a Tony Parker build. So this guy would be from the mid-range to the basket. That's where he gonna get all his bread and butter. Now, I wish they had like Hall of Fame acrobat or a Hall of Fame posterizer or something like that. Just something, you know, just to make me really wanna get this build, because Hall of Fame teardropper, let's be real, who's really gonna use the Hall of Fame teardropper? I mean, look, I'm not gonna lie, I'm gonna use it this year because I was in prelude and I've been practicing on my floater, but I'm just saying, a lot of you guys are not going to use that. So the badges doesn't entice me to want to do this build. But if you look at the stats, look at the three. This is one of the key things I want you guys to look at right here. So when you look at the three-pointer, what you will see is that the three-pointer on this build will max out at a 15. It will max out at a 15, and it will begin at a 12. So maxing this build out at a 15 means that its three-point shot is going to be okay. It's not going to be horrible, but it's not going to be something that you can rely on. But the speed, the vertical acceleration, the ball handling, mid-range, the dunking, and the layups, that's pretty much almost everything, is going to be outrageous. Now, let me just tell you a little bit of these stats real quick. So your layups are going to be 23 when once maxed all the way out. All right. Your dunks will be 20 once maxed all the way out. Mid-range will be 22 once maxed all the way out. Ball handling will be a 20. So I don't know if you're going to be able to speed boost or be able to get those elite crossovers. But if you do, kudos to you. That'd be even better. And then your steals will be one of the highest in this build with 10 to start and 15 to capped out, bruh. So this is one of them builds that if you're gonna make this build, I would say make them at least 6'5", maybe 6'4", all right? So you can get that height, and then make sure you put a little muscle on them, all right? Because you want them contact dunks. You want to boost that contact dunk, but you don't want to take down your speed. So just put a little weight on them. So if the normal weight is 190, just put them like 200, maybe 205. You feel me? Just 205. Just put a little meat on his bones. Pause if I have to, because I know how y'all get, y'all little baby niggas, man. If you got this build, let me know down below in the comment section, please. Let me know if you're about to make this build right here so we can link up and we can talk a little things. You feel me? But that's this build, man. So what we about to do is we about to wrap this video up. So this video's finally reached its end point. Now, if you are one of the ones that actually sat through the whole video, kudos to you, man, because me personally, I couldn't do it. All right, but if you skipped around just to find the build that you wanted to hear me talk about, that's good too, all right? At least you can do for me is give the video a thumbs up. I skip a day of uploading to bring you guys all of this info. All right, it took me a whole day to just sit down and actually make these videos for you guys. So at least you can do is just give me a thumbs up to show me that you appreciate it, all right? So secondly, if you're not already subscribed to the channel, make sure you subscribe to the channel. Make sure you turn on the post notifications so you will get this lit content that's coming to your screen. All right. And also, follow me on Twitter. All right, let's get the Twitter popping. I guess once NBA 2K18 start really getting going, I'm gonna really be on Twitter more, asking you guys questions and stuff like that. And this is what you guys asked for. I gave you a question. I said, would y'all rather see me stream the prelude or not stream it and give you guys all these builds? And this is what you guys asked for. You was like, yo, we don't want you to stream. We want to see these builds. So there's my breakdown of all the builds. If you missed anything, go down below in the description. You will see all the builds from slashers, from shot creators, defenders, post scores. All that will be down below in the description. So go check that out. Go find the build for you. So when NBA 2K18 drop, you will be ready to get that 99 overall. So until the next time, it's your boy, Yo G, and I'm out. Peace.
These motherfuckers mad that I'm icy. Stunt so hard, make them come and date me. I think I'm Big Meech, look at my timepiece. It's an item here, 100 racks at least. Look at yourself, now look at me. You can't see a nigga, I'm what you used to be. Look at it this way, you niggas sideways. Always get